If you want to know how to be the best producer you can be, stay tuned because I've got plenty to share with you. I have been blessed to be working with filmmaker Robert Townsend for the last 17 years. And I also had a chance to work with him before that on the movie Hollywood Shuffle. And I learned a lot about producing. What I want to do is give you the 12 points that I've learned working with Robert the last 17 years. Here we go. Number one, underpromise and overdeliver. When you're working with someone or for someone, never overextend yourself telling them you'll get it really quick. Always give yourself a cushion, either of time or money. So if you know you have to have it in 5 days, take that whole full 5 days. Don't tell them, oh, I can do it in three. If it's a $500 budget, tell them it's a $1,000 budget, because one of the things that people love is to get things done early and get things done under budget. And as a producer, that is your job. And if you do it well and you don't overpromise and don't underdeliver, but underpromise and overdeliver, you are going to be a favorite producer in Hollywood. Number two, time management. Maximizing the 24 hours that you have in a day. One of the things that I learned from working with Robert is always do the biggest pieces first. And if you have priorities, make sure those are handled right away. Example, if you have to make a phone call that's urgent, take care of that immediately. If you have to handle paperwork that has to be returned to unions or managers or agents, handle that immediately. You want to take care of those things that are urgent first, those things that are real bulky first, so that you're not behind the eight ball when you start working on your film and you didn't get it taken care of. Always handle the biggest pieces of production first, and then deal with the little stuff later. It will save you a lot of heartache and it will help you relieve any kind of stress. And most importantly, please don't leave things for the last minute. You'll be glad you took care of it right away. Number three, researching. Researching is very crucial when you're getting ready to go into production. You want to research the best people, the best locations, the best equipment, and make sure that you have between 3 and 5 different sources to pull from. That way, if something falls out or somebody doesn't show up, you can have backup. The problem a lot of times is that producers will only pick one location or one actor or one piece of equipment. And then when it doesn't work, the person doesn't show up, or you can't get the location, you're screwed. So make sure, for your peace of mind and to operate the best production you can, research, 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 and make sure that you have 3 to 5 of everything that you need. Have 3 names of cinematographers or sound people. So if one person leaves, you're not in the lurch. Or if a piece of equipment breaks down, you know where to get it from somewhere else. Number four, resourcefulness. It's not always about money when you're making a project. What I learned from working with Robert is that more times than not, it is about being resourceful. It is about you as a producer figuring out how you can get people to donate their services or their goods to help you with your project. Do you have a community of people, like people from your church or your job or your friends or family, who can come and help you with PAing, getting the catering, providing craft services, helping with locations? It is about how creative you can be in getting stuff done and getting stuff donated without having the financial backing to get it done. And this is where resourcefulness is so needed for a producer. Example, one of the things that we did in Hollywood Shuffle was we had a very large cast and we could not afford catering. So I ended up doing the catering and craft services. I figured out how much we needed to be able to feed this tribe of people. And let me tell you, we got it done and we had food left over and we didn't have to spend a large budget on food. So that's one example of being resourceful. Number five, focus. As a producer, you must focus because you have to have all your wits about you when you're doing production. And you have to anticipate all kinds of situations because you are the one that's gonna be putting out all these fires. You gotta be sharp. Your focus has to be just clear. Anticipate unexpected situations and be ready to make adjustments. You have to have a cool head when you're doing production. Otherwise, things are gonna fall apart and your production is gonna go down the toilet. Number six, rewrites. As a producer, you have to be close to the writer of the project because a lot of times when you're getting ready to do production, things change at the last minute. You can't get a certain location, you lost an actor, just things come up. And you need that writer to do some rewrites to help you. So make sure that you are in touch with the writer, that you are ready to talk to them at a moment's notice, and that they know to be ready to do rewrites on your behalf so that you can have the best project possible. Number seven, don't rush the process. Make sure that you give yourself enough time in pre-production to set as many rehearsals as you need. Bring in department heads to watch. Take care of all the necessary arrangements that you need, like getting your union papers taken care of and everything you need done in pre-production. Because once production starts, the meter is running. And if you waste time during production, you are gonna cost the production a lot of money. So the more you can do in pre-production, the more you can take care of in pre-production, especially rehearsals, because that eats up a lot of time in production, working with the actors. Make sure your actors are available, your director is available. Find a location that everyone can come, including the production heads, to get a feel of what the tone of the film is gonna be while you're rehearsing. Because if you don't, your production is gonna go to hell. Number eight, know your worth. It is so important for you as a producer to know what skills you bring to the table. And please, never undersell yourself when trying to book a job. You know why? Because if you do, you're gonna end up regretting it and you're gonna end up hating that production because they got you on the cheap. Number nine, take risks. Don't ever be afraid to take risks. This is the area where you have to trust your gut. Even though people might say that's a bit risky, but if you know in your gut this is the right call, then you do it. Number 10, preparedness. As a producer, you should be over-prepared for everything on your production. That includes having extra people in your bullpen in case somebody drops out. You're not worried because you got extra hands on set to get the job done. That also means that all your paperwork to the unions or all your paperwork that need to be filled out are taken care of before production starts. It also means that you have anticipated all the problems that could arise before you start production so that you don't miss a beat. It is so important to be overly prepared because that saves you money in the long run. Number 11, keep improving. As a producer, it's not what you know, but what you're learning that will help you for the next project. Every time you do a project, always take inventory and figure out what went wrong or what you learned so that you can carry it into the next project. One of the things that I learned on the last shoot we did was we had a lot of talent who actually didn't have transportation to get to and from the set. And we had not budget money in for that. What I know now is for the next production, we will actually have a line item to make sure that if we have any talent in need, we've got them taken care of. Number 12, make everyone feel special and needed. When you do this, it brings everyone together, and it makes the production crew and cast feel like a real family. Please take care of your people. Make them feel special. Make them feel like they're the most important thing since sliced bread. It really does make a difference. Please take care of your people. As a producer, that is your job. To love on them, to make them feel incredible so that they can give you the best work possible. Don't chintz on them. Make sure you feed them and give them breaks. Do not overwork them, please. Please, 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 please. Love on your people. That's your job as a producer. Yes, it is. With these tools, I was able to move from assistant to assistant producer and now producer. I have found these tools to be valuable, necessary, and transformative in every project I've done. If this video has been helpful to you, type in great info in the comments. And if you have some wonderful info that you'd like to share with us as a producer, we'd love to hear it. Well, that's all I got for you now. See you next time. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, and share the information with your friend. Until next time, see ya.